早餐的魅力了。
手工米粉配手工啤酒，就是因为吃了这些东西，把这里面糯米跟这里边黑芝麻扔到酒里边就出来了。对，在这个城市总得做一点跟过早相关的事情，所以出一款叫过早的酒。
吃一口热干面，来一个过早呀，
这么大的气
还是凉的。
我操，太爽了。
你知道我喝酒两杯。
It's Josh. I'm at Tiao Donghu in Wuhan. It's like a big block party, and the only point is to jump into the lake.
Lately, it seems like craft beer is everywhere in China. I wanted to get to the bottom of this new drinking craze and see where it's headed. I drank my way around the country, meeting different craft brewers fighting for their vision in a lucrative industry that's still ripe for the taking. The first place I went was Wuhan.A city known for its blazing heat and abundant lakes. Every summer, Wuhan locals come to jump into East Lake at an event put on by Guangco and Jiangxi, co-owners of No. 18 Brewing and fixtures of the Wuhan beer scene. Their Tiao Donghu IPA is named after this massive lake party. I followed Guangco and Jiangxi to their brewery to taste it straight from the source.
以前不叫跳动，以前叫十八号酒馆 IPA， 然后后边我们希望自己的 IPA 能够被人家记住，然后就给它取了一个名字叫跳动湖。因为每年夏天当你扎入湖中的那一刹那，就像酒花在你嘴巴里边爆炸那个感觉一样的。
这是 IPA 类型嘛，有大量的美国酒美式酒花在里面，闻起来是很多热带水果的味，那种菠萝、芒果、百香果、葡萄柚，这种荔枝什么，像夏天在海滩边那种沙滩上，然后满眼都是比基尼那种。
我觉得这个就可能是啤酒花，就是葡萄柚的味道，就挺浓的。
这个用的是四种酒花，有三种是，美国那种香花都是。
我觉得喝到好的啤酒倒很简单，你有各种各样的途径可以买得到。但是当你喝完了以后，我发现身边有这样的一个哥们会酿酒，我们就在讨论能不能在武汉也做一个世界级的酒厂起来，这是我们的目标啊。
对你们来说，酿酒最好玩的，就是给你们成就感最大的方面是什么？
做出一个酒，然后啊，大家都觉得好喝，这个是。然后你另外，你做出新的配方来，你做一些融合创新的，也是非常有趣的一个东西。
曾经没有，然后你创造出来一个东西，然后并且实现了，哇，这个才是最酷的事，是吧？
Number 18 Bar is located in a slightly seedy part of town.But at night, the place is packed with regulars. Guangto seemed like Wuhan's undisputed craft beer king. After sharing more than a few beers, he told me about one of his biggest inspirations in the Chinese scene.
如果某一天中国有了自己的风格，而不是什么新西兰式的，或者美式的，或者英式的一个风格，如果有中式的风格的时候，有可能是高岩，不一定是我。高岩在我心中，无论从哪个方面来讲。他都是居功至伟，他让这个行业这么多人看到这个行业，这么多人加入到这个行业，然后他的宽容，他的包容，就是他敢想。
Hearing Guangto's enthusiastic endorsement, I headed to Nanjing to meet Gao Yan, aka Master Gao, the OG of Chinese craft beer. He literally wrote the book on Chinese home brewing, and even coined the Chinese term for craft beer.I met him at his original Nanjing Brewery, arguably the first craft brewing operation in China. Master Gao became infamous for his Baby IPA, a less bitter, sweeter brew tailored to local palates, and other polarizing experiments like a jasmine tea-infused lager.
This is Holy Devil, 火闹鬼。这是啤酒花味儿特别重的一款酒。这酒今天我第一次喝。这个就更接近的 West Coast 那种 IPA。Master Gao 的名字挺好的，又有中国特点，又有那种 arrogant 那种味道，然后又有一个 brewer master 那种概念，对吧？还特别招傻逼们恨，所以说我觉得这个名字好。我现在外面很多人恨我们，也是因为这个名字。
有没有一种感觉，就是 基本上只有你一个人想喝那样的味道，
可以这么说。就你向人解释你为什么要做啤酒的时候也非常困难，别人都认为你有病啊，那么多啤酒那么便宜你不弄，那时候连麦芽都没有，因为我们想买一点麦芽都很困难。我记得刚最早在南京能在一块喝这个 craft beer 的人也就四五个吧，这四五个很多都是我的师弟啊，或者说我的同学啊。那后来这种人群就越来越多，然后我都不认识了，他们就带自己的人，然后后来就光全国都是这个样子。那这时候我们就要去抓住这种社会进步的这种机会，说好我们自己文化要把这个土壤浇上啤酒，
这样就撒点啤酒，
对，撒点啤酒，然后啤酒再变成啤酒，
啤酒就变成钱了。哎，
就是其实
只有茉莉了。Master Gao took me to a local convenience store to see if they stocked his beer.
So we're in a little supermarket in Nanjing and just picked up 4 tall boys of Master Gao's beer. It's pretty much the only craft beer you can get in China in a supermarket because most brewers haven't yet figured out how to legally put it in cans or bottles and sell it.
And the cost of doing so is so high, not many people can bear it.你们为什么没有在冰箱里面放的？
冰箱啊，放的都卖完了。
哦，怪不得。所以说，刚才我又放了四罐进去。好，谢谢你啊。
没事。
再见。
没事。
Thanks for the beer.
Big news in the Chinese beer scene this year was that respected Shanghai brewer Boxing Cat was acquired by AB InBev, the world's biggest beer company, which owns Budweiser and probably most of the other big breweries you can think of. There's a battle over exactly what craft beer means. When a tiny brewery gets bought out by a huge multinational corporation, can you still call it craft?
When I go into a city, in some very remote part of China, and I see someone drinking Boxing Cat,that would be a huge accomplishment. And that would be kind of like the dream that we set out to accomplish, you know, back in 2008, yeah.
Do you think that making the decision to work with a company like AB InBev is something that sort of sets your vision apart from other smaller players in craft beer in China?
Well, it depends on what their goals are, right? Like, if they're happy to just have their microbrewery, their pub, like in their town, and just provide local craft to,the community around them, you know, you could grow very slowly. It just depends on what your vision for your brand is, yeah.
This is Right Hook Helles, 4.5% lager. So pretty balanced, kind of an entryway to maybe craft beer. Strong by kind of jump from industrial lager to craft lager, but.
If you're used to drinking Qingdao or Yanjing, it will taste familiar, yep. But.Definitely a step up.
Yeah, it's gonna have more flavor.
Malty.
The alcohol, yeah, malty, little malt sweetness, a little bit more hops, maybe a little spicy aroma from some of the hops. People say if you get too big, you're not craft. But if you're in America, like that upper threshold of craft by the Brewers Association is really large. It's like 6 million barrels, which is a lot of beer.
Or how many barrels would Boxing Cat be doing now?
2,000.
6 million versus 2,000.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So huge difference. It could be ownership. It could be locally produced. Kind of varies a lot.
What would you say to someone who claims that Boxing Cat just sold out?
Well, we did. I mean, we did sell. So I mean, what's your term? What's your definition of sellout? I mean, I don't know. I don't really know what that means, to be honest. I mean, yes, the company was sold.Yes, 99% of the employees that worked for Boxing Cat still work for Boxing Cat. So things have changed, but generally the things that have changed are for the good.
On the opposite end of the craft beer spectrum in Shanghai is a 24-hour bottle shop that claims to stock 3,000 different beers. It's run by the patron saint of Shanghai drinkers, a local auntie who's only known as the beer lady.
最早的墨迹的时候，我们也是觉得那个时候我们是开杂货店的。那么后来因为淘宝网啊、互联网都做了以后，那么觉得一些传统的行业做不下去了，我就把它改为做国外的进口的精酿啤酒。那么我的宗旨是倡导精酿，马业就是这种精酿的酒的文化得以在上海、全中国来传播，或者世界来传播，都是这样。啤酒是像什么饮料？实际上，啤酒这个市场说句心里话，也是一段高档的液体面包。但是你如果说，可以的话，一天喝了两瓶，也能代表一些主粮。实际上，这个啤酒也是对国内国外来说，也是一种创意呀。所以说，说心里话，每一块精酿啤酒都是 OK 的，只要是精酿，我就给它两个字：健康。来吧，我们来吧，随意好吧。
为了健康，
为了健康，喝精酿。
Beer Lady stocks everything from mass-produced snow beer to snake venom, and Four Loko. The Beer Lady made me wonder: should we really care that much about who makes our beer? When it comes down to it, everyone's just out to have a good time. But there's big money in beer. Of course, people are going to fight over definitions. What I still wanted to know was: what does truly Chinese craft beer look like, and how does it taste?